I used to spend way more time building transitions and crafting title animations than actually focusing on the story I wanted to tell. Hours wasted. Then I came across this platform called MotionVFX. I started testing a few of their packs, bought them with my own money, and honestly, I was impressed. At first, it was just for fun, travel edits, daily stuff, but over time, it turned into a core part of my workflow. So today, I want to share my experience with MotionVFX, what I like, what could be better, and whether it's actually worth your money. Let's jump right in. First of all, I want to disclose that this video is sponsored by MotionVFX, but that has nothing to do with my opinion on their products or my experience, because I started using their stuff way before they ever reached out to me. And turns out they are based in Poland, so technically we are neighbors, which makes this collab even cooler. Okay, so with that out of the way, let's take a look at what cool stuff MotionVFX has to offer. Since I'm editing exclusively in DaVinci Resolve, I'm gonna focus on what's available for Resolve users. And as you can see, there's a bunch of packs to choose from, including some free ones. If you hover over the thumbnails, you'll actually get a quick preview of what's inside. Tons of styles, from podcasts to real estate, from titles to callouts, you name it. Installation is super simple with their M installer, and you can activate your pack on two machines. So you can either share it with a friend or install it on your second setup if you've got one. Alright, now let's take a look at what you can actually do with these plugins. I've picked a few of my favorites from different packs. After installation, all your plugins will show up in the Effects tab, and you can save your favorites for quicker access, which I just did here. So, here's a short clip from my trip to a beautiful place on Earth called Iceland. Let's give it a quick color grade first, and then we'll start dropping some cool stuff on top. If I were a travel content creator, the first thing I would do is build a quick eye-catching intro, and MotionVFX makes that super easy. Here's a quick example. Let's drop an opener from M-Channel Clean Pack. What's great is that you can fully customize the look of your titles, effects, and overlays right inside the plugin. I'll change the titles to match the travel content vibe and adjust the fonts to fit my style. Then I'll drop in my signature logo using the drag and drop feature. Some of the plugins are actually designed to work with multiple clips, like this opener effect. It's built for 7. Just stack your clips on top of each other, turn them into a fusion clip, and then apply the effect to that single combined clip. You'll get a smooth collage-style intro with minimal effort. A quick tip, if you are editing on the 4K timeline, check this 4K checkbox for better quality and correct scaling. Now let's try something a bit more advanced. One of my favorite things to add are callouts, these little graphic elements that pop up to highlight something in your shot. For example, we can tag this Icelandic church right here. First, I'll drop an adjustment clip over the footage, then just drag and drop the callout effect onto it. Type in the correct name of the church, and it's done. But let's take it a step further. You can make your callouts way cooler by adding a bit of motion tracking. Now, tracking isn't built into the plugin itself, but it's easy to do manually in the Fusion page. Here's how. First, I'll drop an adjustment clip over this beautiful shot from Norway. Then I'll add one of the MotionVFX callouts. In this case, I want to tag my friend walking through the landscape. I'll change the title to something like "Walking is good for your health." Now to track it, select the adjustment clip, go to the Effects tab, and hit the magic wand icon. That takes you into Fusion. Inside Fusion, we'll add a basic tracker. Press Shift plus Space, type in tracker and add it. Move the tracking box over your subject and hit the double arrow to track the full clip. You should see little white stripes showing successful tracking. If a few are missing, just retrack those sections and you are good. The last step in the Fusion is to connect the tracking data to the callout's position. To do that, select the callout node, right-click on the center point control, go to Connect to Tracker 1 IntelliTrack 1 Path Position, and that's it. It's now locked onto your subject. After that, we can tweak the callout's look. Maybe remove an extra number, change the font color, or adjust the layout. You can even choose whether the text follows the subject or stays in one spot. Finally, let's connect both clips using a clean transition from another great MotionVFX pack. What I've shown you here is just the tip of the iceberg. MotionVFX has tons of titles, effects, overlays, graphics, basically everything you'd want to level up your edits. Since I started using them, my editing has genuinely improved. And sponsored or not, I would still recommend picking up at least one pack and giving it a shot. It saves a ton of time and your videos will instantly feel more polished. Now, it's not all perfect. For starters, I do wish some of the tracking or masking tools were built in directly into the plugins. But to be fair, that's likely a limitation of the DaVinci side of things. The other thing is pricing. I personally think the products are worth it, but yeah, some of the packs might feel a bit pricey for beginners. The good news, MotionVFX runs sales pretty often, and right now is a great time to check, especially with Black Friday deals just around the corner. You'll find a link in the description. So, is it worth it? No doubt.